Okay, let's have a look at my guitars. So, first one, my newest guitar, the Jackson JS22, upgraded, of course. Yeah, nice guitar. I don't say much here about this guitar because I have another video where I tell about this guitar and the upgrade. So let's move to other one. Okay. This is Gibson traditional Les Paul 2016. Did I say it right? I don't know, but yeah. Gibson traditional Les Paul. Very nice Les Paul. I really like this color. There's not much flame type of thing happening, but I don't care much about that. I just wanted like cherry, what do you call it, top kind of Les Paul. Yeah, it's typical Les Paul. It does Les Paul things. Yeah. Everything else is I upgraded the pickups, which are now Monty's Paps, Alnico 5 neck and Alnico 2 on bridge. If you don't know what are Monty's Paps pickups, then you can find those when you write Google Monty's Paps. These Paps are very nice. Those really are one of the best Paps pickups clones. I think because all what I have heard from videos where someone plays real Les Paul bursts, these pickups seems to have that kind of sound. These are very rich about dynamics. You can really, when you play like on gain, overdrive, these pickups really reacts well when you play hard or soft. And yeah, of course, I changed those capacitors to vitamin C, some old Russian something capacitors. Right now this guitar has 15 NF capacitors. The weight about this guitar is, it's not bad, it's not heavy, but it's not too light either. So it's in the middle. Let's move to another. This is so big that it doesn't fit in the picture. This is hardwood semi-acoustic guitar, yeah, from Gear 4 Music, what it was the side. This is a pretty cheap semi-acoustic clone, but it has this Gibson body model thing going on, like this big body with these horns. These are pretty much like Gibsons, the very round ones. Yeah, also, of course, the headstock is different, but it's pretty good still. It's closer to Gibson types, but not completely. Yeah, I have done also some upgrades to this guitar, and yeah, of course, like Les Paul, these upgrades are pickups and capacitors. So pickups are now Lollar Imperial Low Wines. They recommend these pickups to semi-acoustic and hollow body guitars, and I can say this works very well on semi-acoustic guitars. Like semi-hollow guitars. So bridge pickup is only got 5 and neck pickup is only got 2. These are very nice pickups. Bridge pickup is very bright. It's almost maybe like Gibson T-top kind of sound. Bright and bright. But it fits very well on semi-acoustic guitar. I have some bad playing videos where I use this bridge pickup, this Lollar pickup on my Les Paul too, and it's pretty bright. But if you like that T-top kind of sound, then I think I can recommend the bridge pickup. Yeah, these are nice pickups, but there's one thing that bothers me compared to Monty's Paths, because these pickups sounds good, but these doesn't do those dynamics and the bloom and all kind of those stuffs not as well as those Monty's Paths. Yeah, this like sounds good, but that's it. Not much bloom and those things that you get from Monty's Paths. But these are nice pickups. When you play these, you can definitely hear that these are pretty low output pickups. And of course, because of that, also these are pretty bright pickups. Maybe also because these are a little wax spotted. So maybe that's why these are not as dynamic as Monty's Path set. This guitar has now 22 those old Russian vitamin capacitors. And one thing that I did to this guitar is this hole. Because if you don't do this kind of hole to back of semi-hollow, you have to put all the wires and things from these holes. And I'm not going to do that. So I did a hole to the back. I just don't understand why, like Gibson and other clone semi-hollow makers doesn't do the electronic hole to the back, because it will be so much easier to change wirings and pots and those things. It doesn't affect the sound of this guitar like at all, I think. And you can always cover that hole if you want. This guitar has stock nut and it works. So this guitar keeps the tuning pretty well, but not perfectly. If I don't play it maybe 2 days or three or something, you have to tune this guitar. But when you play this guitar, it stays in tune pretty well. It's pretty amazing because this guitar is is cheap. But I think this is one of the best cheaper semi-hollow guitar clones. Yeah. Those stock pickups wasn't completely bad either, but I wanted just more hikes and those more clear pickups. Let's move then to my best guitar. The Stratocaster one. Yeah, this is my best guitar. The story of this guitar begins 2015 when I starting to want a Strat and starting to know Jimi Hendrix music, and I go to one music store. I was looking a Strat and I saw this Fender American Special Stratocaster. When I first time tried Strat on there on the music shop, I was like blown away, like, oh my goodness. Strat sound was so dynamic, all that I wanted. Of course, like those Les Pauls and others have different sound, but those are again different for different things. But first time when I tried, I was blown away, like man, this guitar is for me. This guitar is maybe my most heavily modded guitar, upgraded, or maybe not upgrade, maybe more like modded. So this guitar was that American Special, but now it's more like Partcaster because this neck is not original. This neck is Squier one, 70s style Squier one neck with a vintage type tuners. So it's crafted in Indonesia. But I didn't like that much that American Professional stock neck. So first I changed the neck to Jimi Hendrix, Fender Jimi Hendrix one. Then I wanted neck that has the headstock right way. So I sold the Jimi Hendrix neck and got this one. And I have been happy since then. This Squier neck is pretty much like that Fender Jimi Hendrix neck, but headstock is like this and not wrong way. Also, I had changed the pickups. This had those America Special something special pickups. I don't know. Those were little too hot for my taste because I wanted that original type Strat sound, which is pretty low output type. So I get Fender 69 custom pickups instead, and these pickups was like so these pickups has been in this guitar after that because these are awesome pickups. these really do the old Strat tones. And very good pickups for Hendrix musics too. These pickups also has some story because I bought these pickups from Thomann, that Germany shop. But the bridge pickup coil wire was broken when I get these pickups. So I had to take the broken wire out and fix and solder the what remains. So the bridge pickup is little lower output than the middle and the neck. And I think here you think and maybe say, why don't you put the bridge pickup to neck? Yeah, of course I could do that, but I have also tried that, but I just like the neck pickup at as full power as the pickup can do, because I didn't like the more low output neck pickup. So that's why I keep the low output bridge on bridge. Neck and pickups are the only upgrades or mods to this guitar. Otherwise, the body electronics are stock ones. Oh yeah, except I changed because this guitar had that some, what it was, middle, I don't know what it was, something, this guitar had something going on with the pots thing. I removed that and now this is like normal Strat. So the body is American special one, made in USA. The neck is the only thing that is made in Indonesia. This and that Gibson Les Paul are the guitars that if I have had to sell some guitars, I would keep this and Gibson. So the amps I have the Rickstone made Marshall 2061X clone amp. And then I have the Hughes and Gettner Stageman EL34 amp. Those amps are very nice amps, but I have always want Marshall Plexi head. And I'm like after Marshall head, but I don't have the money yet, so we'll see, will I ever get one? But that's like that Gibson Les Paul was one dream of mine to get a real Gibson, good Gibson Les Paul, and that one is done. Now I have to get the Marshall Plexi type head. That's the second one. But we'll see. That Rickstone clone does pretty much a Marshall thing, at least with Marshall type pedal. But it's not completely what I want, and because it is 20 watts. It's not as there's not as much headroom and those things that you can get with 50 watts and 100 watts. But yeah, this was the stories of my guitars. So thanks for watching.